Welcome to video 3, which explores different assertive techniques to say no and why saying no may be difficult. Communication is a complex activity that involves verbal and nonverbal aspects, as well as language used, the topic under discussion, the history of the participants, and their beliefs, values, and judgments that they bring to the conversation. Ineffective communication occurs when the meaning of a message is misunderstood. The Assert Yourself workshop has 3 videos for you to access. Video 1 looks at passive and aggressive communication styles, breaking down the verbal and nonverbal characteristics of each. We take a brief look at the passive-aggressive communication style and analyze the cost and benefit of using each communication style. Video 2 breaks down the components of the assertive communication style, looking at verbal and nonverbal characteristics, exploring roadblocks to acting assertively, so addressing some of those things that might be getting in the way of expressing ourselves in a clear and direct manner, and learning I statements, which is the basic message of assertive communication, which will help address the language we use to articulate our thoughts, feelings, and beliefs. Video 3 explores different ways of saying no and why saying no can be difficult. Why saying no assertively is important. We live in a world where we have frequent demands on our time and energy, and we cannot possibly say yes and meet all these demands. Inability to say no leads us to doing things less well. If we don't have boundaries and we take on too much, it will be difficult to do a great job at everything. Performance will suffer, our relationships suffer, our health will suffer. Saying yes when we want to say no can result in a buildup of anger and resentment, can lead to angry outbursts, and can affect our health and self-esteem. Saying no can be difficult, and even people who are assertive in other ways can find it hard to say no. Learning to say no assertively is essential to help us communicate healthy boundaries, let others know what they can expect from us. It garners more respect and allows us to have more control over how we live our life. Here's our example of saying no.
So I'm just trying to figure out why you decided to meet with me. I mean, you've been ducking me, and then all of a sudden...
My little sister's getting married.
Ah, before you.
That's not what I'm upset about.
And what are you upset about?
You don't know Tess. She's gonna want me to do everything. I'm not gonna just be her maid of honor. I'm gonna be taking care of everything.
So why don't you just say no?
What?
Say no. You have said no to people before, haven't you?
Yes, of course. Many, many times in this situation. Never. Not once.
Bobby, you want to say no.
But I can't. It's my sister.
But you can say no because it's your sister. All right. You know what we're going to do? We're going to practice, all right? We're going to practice saying no. You think I'm kidding? Turn around. We're going to play this game. Come on. Humor me. All right, Jane, give me $50.
No.
Jane, it's $50. I'll pay you back.
No.
I need you to give me $50.
No.
Yeah, it's not bad. Have your drink.
Sure. No! Oh, no!
You were doing so well. That's terrible. Mm-hmm.
This is a good example of how it may be difficult to say no in certain situations or relationships that we have, and the importance of preparation and practice. Why is it hard to say no? Family values, gender, culture, the expectation of saying yes, all can contribute to difficulties in saying no. We learn to say no early on in life. Small children are great at saying no. Over time, we can develop some unhelpful beliefs about saying no. Some of the unhelpful thoughts could be that saying no is rude, aggressive, selfish, or unkind. It will hurt or upset someone. Other people's needs are more important than mine. Maybe a family value is to respect your elders, and saying no is a sign of disrespect. We don't want to rock the boat or cause conflict, and we want to be nice. If saying no is hard for you, then it can be valuable to take the time to consider some of the beliefs that make it difficult for you. Exploring where these beliefs come from is a helpful way to learn to let them go. If unhelpful beliefs are a roadblock to expressing yourself assertively, consider challenging them. Are these thoughts 100% true? Are they helpful? If not, we can change these thoughts by adding a new or more helpful belief, one step at a time. Some examples are, other people have the right to ask, and I have the right to refuse. I am refusing the request, not rejecting the person. Saying yes means less time with friends, family, or for self-care. Saying no doesn't make me a bad person. Better to say no now than to feel resentful later. Sometimes we want to say no, but we just don't know how. This is where practice is helpful. The first technique to saying no is the direct no, where we just say no. We don't provide a reason, explanation, excuse, or an apology. The example here, would you like a free sample? And the reply is no, or no thank you. Next, we have the reflecting no. Here is where we recognize the feeling behind the request. It is softer, but the boundary is still clear that you cannot meet the request. Example, I know you're stuck and need someone to babysit the kids tonight, but I am unable to watch them tonight. The reasoned no is when we say no and we give a reason why. This is often overused and is almost automatic. Be careful. Use this sparingly because the minute we provide reasons or excuses, it gives others the opportunity to talk us out of it or look for ways around to obtain a yes. It sets us up to have to justify why we are saying no and invalidates our needs. It's also important to avoid giving reasons that aren't fully true, as we may get caught in a white lie or have to deal with resulting guilt later on. The example here is, I can't go to dinner with you tonight. I have a family commitment. Unlike other techniques, the rain check no is not a definite no. With this no, you suggest another time when you are able to say yes. Use this honestly and only if you actually want to say yes to the request. Otherwise, you'll find yourself having to say no again down the road. Example here, I can't do lunch today. How about next week? This last technique, called the broken record, is a very effective tool for asserting a boundary. It works well with I statements as well as for saying no. Here we are firm and clear, and we repeat a simple statement over and over until the message is understood and the boundary is apparent. So the example, we have someone being pressured to go for lunch. Come out for lunch with me. No, I'm sorry. Being genuine and saying sorry only if you are actually sorry. I can't have lunch with you. It won't take long. No, I'm sorry I can't have lunch with you. It's my treat. No, I'm sorry, but I can't have lunch with you. Practice this technique so you are skilled to use it when you need it in high-pressure situations. This activity is a good self-reflection and opportunity to practice some of the assertiveness skills discussed. Spend a few moments and think of a situation or a conversation that you've had before or you may need to have that is difficult. Think of what you would like to say or normally say and see if you can revise this using an assertive approach by using I statements or saying no. People in our lives are used to having us react and respond in predictable ways. Maybe we typically go along with what they suggest, or we say yes to their requests. When we change our response, it will likely impact them, and their needs may no longer get met by us. expect resistance. Consider having a conversation with those around you, letting them know you are planning on making a change in your communication. Do this before making this change to prepare them for what to expect. This could sound something like, I want to let you know that I'm going to be making some changes to support my health and wellness. I may be talking more about what I think and how I feel, and I may also be saying no more often. That way, when you find yourself in a situation where you want to be more assertive, you can refer back to the conversation and say to them, remember when I told you I was going to be making some changes? This is one of those times. This will help to emphasize that your change in behavior is not about them, but about you. Learning to communicate more assertively takes time and practice, just like learning to master any skill. So give yourself the time and practice you need. When making changes, start with one small concrete goal. We are more effective in climbing the mountain in 30 small steps versus trying to do it in 3 giant leaps. Small steps build towards success. And pay attention to successes. You are probably already able to be assertive sometimes or with some people, and these are skills that you already have available to you. Need more? If you're interested in more information related to assertive communication, please check out the additional resources section posted within this workshop recording. This brings us to the end of video 3, concluding the Assert Yourself workshop. Thank you for attending. Your medical home is here to work with you to take care of your health care needs. Have a wonderful day.